name is Eliosef Malkieli and I am 26. I grew up in Kibbutz Migdal Oz near Jerusalem. In 2011, I joined to the Golani Brigade Special Force Unit. During the period of Operation Protective Edge, I had a platoon commander. I commanded 30 soldiers and was responsible for their personal safety and readiness for war. In one of the nights, we entered Gaza. My department's mission was to occupy a huge house that controlled the entrances of terrorist tunnels, and we received information that the house contained armed terrorists. In this point, they started to fire at us, and we returned fire. And to be sure that the room will be clean of terrorists, I threw a grenade into the room. The grenade hit the ceiling, and like a bad movie, the grenade flew directly back to us into the Namer. We were just 3 seconds from the moments that the grenade thrown until it explodes. We had nowhere to run, and all one in range of 8 meters from the grenade is used to die. In order to block the sharpness and the harm from my soldiers, I threw myself on the grenade. And the grenade exploded below me. He threw me and smashed my my arms and my legs. But in a miracle that is hard to explain, I remained alive. I injured very bad. I lost a lot of blood. And they evacuated us by helicopter to the hospitals. I didn't know if my soldiers were alive and if I will stay alive, and if so, would my legs and my arm will stay with me. I woke up after a few days in the intensive care unit, lying weak and helpless. In this moment, it starts 2 years of rehabilitation to move from wheelchair to crutches to walking stick. I managed to move one finger, later the another, and to close all my hand. During my rehabilitation, came to visit me a lot of peoples from all Israel, but not just from Israel, came to visit me from all over the world, from the United States, from South Africa, from England, Europe. And I remember how excited I was to see the warm embrace from all over the world. I was ready to give my life for my soldiers, for the country of Israel. But Baruch Hashem, I am here. I lost a lot of friends that aren't with us today. For me, it's very important to remember them and to remember their legacy. And I try all the time to walk in their ways and to be more happy. I think it makes me a better person. I realized from the peoples that visited me the strong connections of the Jews all over the world. I think that even if you don't know the specific soldier, for his family, it's very big. It showed to us that the Jews outside of Israel care, and we feel like we are the Jewish nation. One nation, one people, like a big family in all over the world. Thank you.
הוא היה חבר שלי, הוא היה בן שלי, הוא היה הכל בשבילי. ובעצם מבחינתי, כשהוא הלך, הוא לקח איתו הכל, הוא לקח את השמחה, הוא לקח את הצחוק, הוא לקח את החיוך, הוא לקח את האור, הוא לקח הכל, הוא השאיר.
כל הזמן היינו בונים פה אוהלים בסלון או בחדרים, משחקים כדורגל כל הזמן בבית, שוברים דברים.
הוא היה כזה חכם, הוא עשה 38 יחידות בגרות. חבר'ה בשכבה היו מתפתחים שיש לו מחברת אחת לכל המקצועות וגם יריקה. הוא הלך על גבעתי בעקבות אור, הוא ממש רצה להגיע לגצר, לסיירת.
שלום לכם. הפסקת האש נכנסה הבוקר ב-8 לתוקף.
התקשרתי אליו. טוב, אמרתי לו, נו, אז שמעתי שצריך להיות הפסקת אש וזה, אתה בא הביתה וזה? אמר לי, כן. אני אבוא. אמרתי לו, אתה בא סוף שבוע? אז הוא אמר לי, אני יוצא לרגילה. ככה עם הומור כזה וזה. הוא אמר, אבא, אתה יודע מה? אני חושב שאני יוצא למיוחדת. והוא יצא למיוחדת.
בדרך החוצה מהבית, הצלם מאיר דהן מתעכב לרגע על שני לוחמים שיושבים על המדרגות. אמר ראשון, ליאל גדעוני, שיושב למעלה. נהרג גם הוא בתקרית הבוקר ברפיח.
מבית שמח, מלא צחוקים ואנשים ו... אוכל, יהיה בית עצוב ושקט.
שלום, my name is Marlene Annabelle Artev and I am from Olami, New York. I am super honored that I can give my birthday as a day of commemoration and honor to all the brave men and women that served in the IDF and protected our country. Lael Gidoni, on top of being a fearless warrior in the Gavati Brigade, was also a brother, a son, and a smiling friend to many.
Lael היה ילד מדהים, מלא שמחת חיים, מלא נתינה, מלא אהבה.
Sergeant Gidoni fell in the battle in Rafah on August 1st, 2014, at just 21 years old. I'm turning 21 myself this Tuesday, on Yom Hazikaron. This is the same age that Lael made the ultimate sacrifice of giving his life in order for all of us to continue living as one Jewish people.
Hi, Marlene.
Nice to meet you, Naim Meod.
When we saw the video, it was... amazing is the most closed word.
It was such an amazing opportunity for me to do that because of what your son and the brave men and women in the IDF, because of what they do, I'm safe here.
הוא היה ילד מאוד צנוע וענב, שאני לא יודעת איך הוא היה מקבל את כל זה שמדברים עליו כל כך, אבל הוא גם היה ילד כל כך מיוחד ונדיר שאי אפשר שהוא פשוט ייעלם כך ולא להמשיך להשמיע אותו. הוא תמיד תמך ועזר ותמיד היה שם לתת כתף, לתת עצה טובה. הוא היה עומד פה בחלון שאתה רואה אחריך, ואם הוא היה רואה את אחת השכנות יורדת עם הסלים, היה מדלג את המדרגות 5-5, קופץ לעזור להם לעלות סלים הביתה. הוא אהב מאוד חברים, בית שלנו היה מלא בחדרים. איך שהוא היה מגיע, הוא היה מתחיל להתקשר לכולם להגיע ולהיות פה.
Did he have any plans, you know, for university or after the army?
אין שאף, שאף ללמוד רפואה.
I've never had the pleasure of meeting Lael, but to him I just wanted to say thank you. thank you not just for your service, but for all the joy that you have brought to this earth. As I read about you, I learned that you were always smiling, always there for those in need, a great leader, and that you hated goodbyes.
הוא לא יהיה רק בארץ, הוא יהיה גם בעולם. להפיץ אותו, להפיץ את הדרך, לנסות לשנות, באמת, להיות אנשים טובים יותר. כשאני מרצה ומספרת על ליאל, בסוף אני מבקשת לקחת משהו מליאל, את השמחת חיים, את האופטימיות, את הדרך ארץ, את החיוך.
I will try my best to be joyful and be selfless and be modest and think about him and say shema for him.
Thank you.
אנחנו מזמינים אתכם לישראל.
You know, God willing, if I'm in Israel this summer, I definitely want to meet you in person. I would love to stay in touch and call you sometime and talk again. Thank you so much. Toda rabah.
Toda.
Bye. Bye.
I heard the door. The minute I heard an Israeli accent, I thought something's wrong. And he just said there's been an accident. And I said, oh, I said, is he okay? What happened? Or, you know, like, how severely is he injured? They kept kind of staring at me, just looking at me. And then I said, I think I must have said, did he die or is he dead? And then they said, yes.
Max and my sister Paige and myself, we all decided to go to Israel on our birthright trip.
Part of his trip was to go to the Mount Herzl.
When he went to the cemetery, Mount Herzl, I think that really, really impacted him.
We were told that he had made a statement out loud that I'm going to come back and I'm going to do what these guys did, to serve and to protect Israel. We didn't recognize or believe how passionate he was about this.
He absolutely would not do anything but Golani, and he wanted Golani 13. And they told him no at first, and he's like, I don't care, send me home, send me to jail. That's it.
Just looking at him makes you smile, yeah. Because Max's smile was, you know, from ear to ear.
This is where my love for Israel is. They were so appreciative of our son sacrificing his life.
30,000 people is a lot of people. It was very moving. You realize, you know, your life has meaning, and you have only a certain amount of time to, you know, live it right. And you know, that's a constant reminder from the day it happened until the rest of my life.
I think that was his mission. I think it was his mission. And you know what? Mission accomplished.
I flew to Los Angeles from Chicago to meet Evie Steinberg. Max Steinberg's mom. My daughter was in the Army during the same time that Max was in, and I've thought about him and his parents often.
Max had joined the Army. He was serving in the Golani Brigade, and he was very proud. He was a very good sharpshooter. When Max, unfortunately, was killed in action, it seemed that Joelle really took it to heart and really meant a lot to her to honor him and to show gratitude. So today, I have the honor of meeting her.
Hi, Joelle. Welcome to LA. Nice to meet you. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you. Chicago, huh?
Chicago.
Oh boy. Okay. Come on in.
Okay.
Come on in.
See your very messes. I didn't know you. I just wrote a little blurb on the memorial site and just wanted to express my condolences. And it's really an honor to be able to come here and connect with you as a mother.
It's an honor for me. And I know
it's
Max.
It's such an honor.
Max would be honored that you're here.
Well, thank
you. He really would be.
So anyway, I'm going to take you into Max. I call it Max's room. It was never his room. He's never lived here before. But in here I have some things from his childhood, from the army, from high school, whatever, just things about Max. But I come in here sometimes when I feel I need to be close to him, or people come over, want to see things, I bring them in here. So I'll show you a few things that are pretty special. He was a huge Bob Marley fan. Huge. In fact, on his gravesite, you've seen the quote.
Yes.
For yourself. And yes. I know that's Max. This pin, every war has a pin.
Right.
So this is the Tsukitan pin.
Right.
He always bragged about his scope he had. It's just been everybody else's, his scope.
He had a special scope.
Oh, yeah.
Sure.
They always talked about it. And they told me they found it. It was an explosion in the fire, but they found it. This is a piece of his scope. Wear it, but you can put it into a drawer, but there's Max's tag right there.
To see Max's stuff, to see the things that people sent in honor of him after he passed, was both heartbreaking and uplifting at the same time. It's beautiful to have these memories, and I'm sure very painful as well.
Joelle is here to honor my son. It helps me in my grieving process. Because I know it, first of all, that it reconfirms that how happy I am that Max is buried in Israel. Because I know that when you go to Israel,
I think about him when I go to see him.
You get to see, you see him.
Yeah.
The last, I'd say, 4.5 years, we're very involved in helping other families of lone soldiers. And that's pretty much what keeps me going, is knowing that I can help other parents.
I'm very happy that I came and I got to meet Evie and hear more about Max. And we got to make a deeper connection, and I have a feeling that we're gonna stay connected and do more good together.
תמיד היא הייתה מחבקת אותי ואני מחסת לשם ביחד לפעמים במיטה. כאילו מתקרבלות, ברוב שהייתה מאוד מחוברת אליי. מאוד.
אבוש, הייתה קורא לי כל הזמן אבוש. מבין כזה בצחוק ומכות כאלו בצחוק.
ממשיכים מאמצי ההחייאה בשוטרת משמר הגבול שנפצע אנושות בפיגוע הדקירה והירי בשער שכם בירושלים.
ברגע שהגיע קצין הנפגעים לעבודה שלי ולקח אותי לבית חולים בירושלים ואמר לי שהדר פצועה, אז ידעתי שהגרוע מכל קרה.
שקשה לי, זה כמו סוג של מועקה שפתאום אני רוצה אותה לידי. אז אני הולכת לבית העלמין, שוטפת הקבר, מדברת איתם, מדליקה נר. בוכה. בחלום כבר קרה לי פעמיים שהיא באה ופשוט אמרה לי, אמא, אל תדאגי, אני כאן.
אני זוכרת את עצמי, באמת מגיל נורא נורא קטן, יושבת בקהל, ככה מתרגשת מהזיקוקים. מאז שאני זוכרת את עצמי, אני בטקס יום העצמאות בארץ, תמיד התחלתי את הערב שלי פה. זה היה, אי אפשר לפספס את זה, אי אפשר לוותר על זה. זה טקס עם עוצמה אדירה, והוא תמיד מרגיש מחדש, ו... יש פה המון כוח, המון ממלכתיות, וזה טקס מדהים לטעמי. שנה שעברה הגעתי לפה בתור חיילת, ואמרתי לעצמי, אני רוצה שנה הבאה לבוא בתור קצינה ולהצדיע, וזהו, ועכשיו אני פה בתור צועדת, זה אפילו מיוחד יותר.
הנה כאן תמונות אחרונות שצילמנו. סגן הילה בצלאלי זיכרונה לברכה, מתאמנת לקראת הטקס עליו חלמה כל חייה. עוד כשעתיים יקרוס כל מגדל התאורה ויגדע את חייה.
For our mitzvah project, we have chosen to honor two of Israel's fallen heroes. Hila Bezaleli was born in Jerusalem in 1991. Hadar Cohen was born in Or Yehuda on the 31st of March 1997, the daughter of Sigalet and Ofer Cohen.
Effectively, this was meant to be a small project of the girls learning for their bat mitzvah year in honor of two soldiers. And we never would have dreamed that the Bezaleli family would have come from Israel to South Africa.
עלינו היום למטוס, מאוד מאוד מתרגשים, גם חוששים, לא יודעים את מי נפגוש, מה נפגוש, איך יהיה.
We are on our way to meet Hila's parents at the airport. I'm feeling excited because it'll make it so real for me.
כשראינו את הילדות המתוקות האלה, נפתח לנו הלב, זה שווה הכל.
זה כל כך מרגש, זה כל כך לא מובן מאליו. שני ילדות בקצה השני של כדור הארץ, מקבלים אותנו, אין מילים.
When I met them, I was very excited because I knew my bat mitzvah simcha has started. Hadar Cohen fell in battle on the 3rd of February 2016. She was just 19 years old. On the 18th of April 2012, as a result of a tragic staging accident, Hila lost her life. She was just 20 years old. Mr. and Mrs. Bezaleli, we hope that knowing your daughter is remembered and honored brings comfort to you and your family. Anachnu mekavot ki zikaron beshem betekes. מנחם אתכם ולו במעט.
האירוע הזה היום זו הילה שלנו, זה ילדים, כולנו שווים, כולנו אנשים טובים.
זה מה שהילה רצתה, ואנחנו ממשיכים את דרכה ונמשיך את דרכה.
אני מבחינתי עושה את המיטב ועולה גם אם זה בפעם המאה ועושה את הטוב ביותר והכי משתדלת וזה לא תמיד קל ולא תמיד כיף אבל מבחינתי אני עושה את הטוב ביותר.
I think it is quite an incredible thing to be able to recognize fallen soldiers that have played such a pivotal role in the reason why we can have Jewish day schools around the world.
While people in Israel might feel that they mourn on their own and they alone feel the pain, they must know that all around the world, Jewish people mourn with them and feel their pain.
To have two bat mitzvah girls who choose to link their bat mitzvah in honor of the fallen heroes of Israel has made for such an incredibly moving occasion in the school.
These girls have walked a journey this year. On many levels, and I think this has been an enlightening moment for them.
אני חושב שהאסמבלי הזה מראה את הקשר שבין התפוצה היהודית בדרום אפריקה לבין מדינת ישראל.
אנחנו אחד, אנחנו לא נפרדים, הם מבינים את המסע החשוב והרציני הזה של חיילי צבא הגנה לישראל.
אני לא יכולה להסביר מה שאנחנו עוברים בימים האלה, מה שעברנו היום, זה נתן לנו בפנים לראות מה זה אנשים טובים, מה זה יהודים כולם, זה לא משנה איפה אנחנו נמצאים. וזה נותן את הכוח להמשך.